election, people doing things out of the ordinary when people were confused and, you know, didn't really know how to do stuff. They were, you know, I just witnessed a couple really nice events, and it was great. And at the end of the night, when I was looking for results, and then I was looking at other cities, ours were up really fast, and other cities took days. So, I mean, we were on it, you know. So I just wanted to also say thanks and just commend you guys for an awesome job.
To note on that, on behalf of Clerk Bauer, thank you everybody for participating in the election, those who did, especially our workers. We can't run the elections without our election inspectors. We really rely heavily on them, and they work very well with us. They spend a lot of hours, and frankly, you know, they get paid, but it's nothing what they truly deserve for all the work that they do and what they deal with. So we thank them. We couldn't do it without them. We did have a 49.95% voter turnout, which is, it doesn't sound high, but I promise you it is high, especially for a midterm election. And just as a reminder, there are no scheduled elections next year in 2023. If there's a special one scheduled, we'll announce it, but there are no scheduled elections until the presidential primary of 2024.
All right. Well, you know, we can change that.
Then you want to give me some vacation days? It's already good fellow time, so.
Gotta have a little fun. Well, thank you. Any, for the record, just so that we're in alignment, note that Councilman Slavin arrived at me at 6:38. We had Gavin's excuse in the early minutes, and it came in just from the notes, because we'll record that as excuse with them.
Excuse.
Mark is excused. All right. Let's just do some paperwork here. Any further local business from the council? Yes?
Through the chair, just some, speaking of good fellows, as you just voted on tonight, as a reminder, we do have our newspaper drive November 25th through the 27th, and then December 3rd and 4th, so you will see your volunteers out in the intersections with their newspapers. Be sure to swing by, give them some cash, and get one of those papers. We also do take donations online. Be sure to check out our Facebook page for more information. We also, for those who are unable to volunteer, they aren't able to stand in the rows, or they just don't want to, that's okay. There are other ways to be involved with the Good Fellows. You can adopt a family, you can adopt a child, and shop for that child. We do have that information on our Facebook page. You can also just reach out to me in the clerk's office, or again by contacting us through Facebook, and we'd be happy to set you up with that. Do be sure to reach out soon. The deadline to turn in the items for children that are adopted is December 9th, because there's a lot of work on the back end about organizing all of that. They just want to say thank you to all of our volunteers. I know there are a couple council members that help us as well, and we really appreciate it, and so do the families.
Thank you. Any further open business from the elected officials? If not, is there any open business from the audience? Please come forward.
Nicholas Meschina, 968 Campbell. I've got two items to speak on in relationship to the Veterans Museum. If the chair would grant me leeway to speak on both of those items, I'd like to do that.
Great.
If not, I can sit down and get up again and be recognized. First off, this weekend on the 19th at the VFW between 5 and 8 p.m., you're having a spaghetti dinner. The cost will be $10 donation, and that is to support the Veterans Museum. That was an open invitation to all residents of Taylor, the surrounding communities, our city council elected officials, and particularly our team members on the council who are veterans, Councilman Ramick and Councilman Slade. The second item I'd like to discuss is one of the veterans that we have a display cabinet for, unfortunately, is not doing very well right now, some health issues. And I would like to speak on her behalf and discuss her career with the Army. Command Sergeant Major Joan Briggins served for 26 years in the United States Army from 1975 to 2001. She graduated from Central Michigan University in 1973, was a teacher for 2 years in Detroit prior to enlisting into the Army. She enlisted with the Women's Army Corps at Fort McClellan, Alabama. During her 26-year career, served as a drill instructor, or sorry, Councilman Ramek, forgive me. A drill sergeant, a first sergeant, a recruiter, and was also the first female first sergeant at the primary leadership development course in Fort Hood, Texas. Command Sergeant Major Briggins. Personal awards include Legion of Merit with 2 Oak Leaf Custers for 3 awards. That is the third highest award in peacetime. The Meritorious Service Medal with 3 Oak Leaf Custers for a total of 4 awards. The Army Commendation Medal with 3 Oak Leaf Custers for a total of 4 awards. The Army Achievement Medal with 3 Oak Leaf Custers for a total of 4 awards. The Army Good Conduct Medal with Silver Clasp and 2 Loops for a total of 8 awards. Is that correct, Councilman Wright? I wasn't sure on that.
Okay.
No, thank you. And the National Defense Service Medal. Thank you.
Thank you. There's Mr. Chairman, Councilman, there's something that we all chose to know about Joan, Command Sergeant Major. She was the first woman to serve in Germany as the Command Sergeant Major of the Big Red One, with a female, which is astronomically unbelievable. And she was so dedicated to that unit, I think her uniform says it all. And she really loved the military in this country. And she was a great lady, truly a great person. Councilman Johnson.
So a few weeks ago, one of her friends, she actually retired teacher too from Taylor. So one of her fellow teachers got a hold of me and she was in the museum and didn't see her uniform. I didn't know where it was because everything was moved over, put in boxes. So we found it, me and Nick, and we put it together one night so that that could be the picture taken, gets back in the cabinet and sent to her because she's down in Texas right now and she's fighting some health issues, and we thought this would give her a boost.
And I will note, we still have a minute left and you went through 2 questions, but follow up, how can people purchase tickets?
There are no tickets to be purchased for the fundraiser. It is a pay at the door event.
Thank you.
That is in the 19th from 5 to 8 p.m. at the VFW on Pine Street, Jersey.
All right, thank you. Any further open business from the public?